The Agriculture Department rolls out its 43 pesos per kilo rice for all program. Let's get details now from our correspondent, Jervis Manahan. Jervis, over to you.
Yes, Carmina, cheaper rice at 43 pesos per kilo will be available in Caniwa stores of the Department of Agriculture starting October 11, Friday. This is 2 pesos lower than the initial selling price of 45 pesos per kilo under the Rice for All program. The program kicked off in a Caniwa store in Barangay Daang Pasal in Masabuyong City. Agriculture Secretary Francisco T. Laurel Jr. said he is happy with the warm reception of the public to the program. T. Laurel said the department will not be shelling out money to subsidize the rice, as this is the actual price from farmers directly sold to consumers. The Agri-Chief hopes the program will be sustainable as they have already enough stock to sell until February next year, despite more Caniwa stores opening across Metro Manila and other areas of Luzon soon. There is no limit to purchases of 43 pesos per kilo rice, but T. Laurel Jr. appeals to public to only buy what their families can consume. T. Laurel is also hopeful they can further bring the price down to 39 pesos if the peso value continues to strengthen. The program, while aimed at helping consumers, is also beneficial for farmers. Levi Bautista, a farmer from Alcala, Pangasinan, said the program will give them direct access to consumers without the need for middlemen. Bautista said that currently, 5,000 farmers from their group will benefit with the program. The rice harvest will be sold directly to the consumers with no haggling from abusive traders. Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Jervis Manahan, there joining us on the line. Over in Mualboal, Cebu, authorities uncover a suspected pogo operation inside a resort. Our very own Annie Perez on the line now with that story. Annie, what more can you tell us?
Yes, that's right, Carmina. The Bureau of Immigration and the Philippine National Police are still continuing their documentation and investigation on the presence of 38 undocumented Chinese nationals who were discovered in a resort in the town of Mualboal, Cebu. This stemmed from an operation conducted Wednesday afternoon at Barangay Saavedra when the local government unit was conducting a routine inspection of the establishments in the town. According to the chief of Mualboal Police Station, Police Major Brigido Paca, the LGU, along with the Bureau of Fire Protection, sought assistance when they saw foreigners inside the resort during their inspection. When they talked to some of these Chinese nationals, Paca said that they were reasoning out that they were in Cebu for a vacation. But when they saw the rooms that they rented, they saw a lot of computers, laptops, cell phones, and even printers. When they also came in, only one out of 38 was able to present a passport, but it was in the form of a digital photograph on a cell phone. Not one of them held their physical passport. In an interview, the mayor of the town said that they were curious about the resort when the guests inside requested for high-speed internet. And based on their assessment, it seems like this is one of the requirements for an establishment to conduct POGO activities. Indeed, it was the Municipal Planning and Development Office and the Business Processing and Licensing Office that initiated the inspection. At the moment, they are now being held at the resort pending investigations and possible violation of immigration laws. And the authorities are keen that what they saw in plain view and based on their initial investigation, that these are all indicators of illegal POGO activity. They found out that the Chinese nationals checked in September 24, and only three logged and checked in the resort. And they were shocked that they reached this number. The Department of Justice, the Criminal Investigation and Detection Unit, including the Regional Anti-Cybercrime Unit, are also on site to conduct their investigation. And as we speak, they're also in coordination with the Chinese consulate since the foreigners could not speak in English. They're also trying to link if what they found in Mualboal is also in connection with the discovered POGO hub in Barangay Agos, Lapu-Lapu City, sometime August and September. That's the latest here in Cebu. Annie Perez, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks a lot, Annie Perez, there joining us on the line. It's the final day of the ASEAN Summit in Lao PDR, where the region's leaders just finished a meeting with U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken. Katrina Domingo is still monitoring developments there. She joins us live with the latest. Kat, over to you.
Hi, Hi, Carmina. That's right. On the final day of the ASEAN summit here, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and other Southeast Asian leaders met with U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken, who is representing U.S. President Joe Biden in this year's conference. In that meeting, Blinken condemned China for its increasingly dangerous and unlawful actions in the South and East China Seas. Let's listen to that statement.
We remain concerned about China's increasingly dangerous and unlawful actions in the South and East China Seas, which have injured people and harmed vessels from ASEAN nations and contradict commitments to peaceful resolution of disputes. The United States will continue to support freedom of navigation and freedom of overflight in the Indo-Pacific. We also believe it's important to maintain our shared commitment to protect stability across the Taiwan Strait.
President Marcos Jr. thanked the U.S. for its consistent support for ASEAN nations and described the world's largest economy and military as a force for peace, stability, and security in the region. Carmina, we all know that the U.S. has consistently supported the position of the Philippines against China in the West Philippine Sea. But it is also important to note that Washington is also the biggest source of investments for most, if not all, ASEAN nations. Marcos Jr. told Blinken that the Philippines will continue to support Washington's initiatives in the region, especially those that advance the collective peace, stability, and prosperity in Southeast Asia. Carmina, right now, President Marcos Jr., as well as other ASEAN leaders, are still in the meeting, specifically the East Asia Summit. That's quite important here because, aside from ASEAN leaders, also participating in that meeting are the representatives of the U.S., China, Japan, South Korea, New Zealand, Australia, and even Russia. We are still in a wait-and-see mode on what they have discussed there because it is a closed-door meeting, so we have no direct access as to what the leaders, specifically President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., mentioned during his speech in that said forum. Carmina, President Marcos Jr., as well as U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken, are expected to hold separate press conferences later in the day, so we will keep you posted on what happens next. Carmina.
And we will wait for that. Our very own Katrina Domingo there joining us live from Lao PDR. Thanks again, Kat.